you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. So, I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs, so I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular, in other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hello lovely Virgo, this is your reading for the month of July 2017, your angelscope, tarotscope, astrological overview. And so for you, we've got the sun in the 11th house in Cancer, and you're very much going to be looking at your sense of belonging and community this month, in terms of how it relates to your emotional well-being. So, and not only in terms of your emotional well-being, but just generally, how do you connect with people? How do you connect with the wider community? How do you feel about yourself within the context of a community, or the various communities that you interact with? Have you become a bit isolated? Is it time for you to reach out a bit more? Do you have time and space now to reach out, whereas you haven't for quite some time? So this is all going to be a really, really interesting time for you to re-emerge into the wider community, and also to have a greater sense of your place within it and the gifts that you came to give to that community. It's also the house of hopes and dreams and wishes, the 11th house. So with a focus being on your 11th house, you're basically going to be looking at what you're planning, what you're wishing for, what you're wanting to manifest now, and how you can manifest that in a wider community, and also whether there are ways for you to work within the community that's beneficial to everyone. So in other words, Virgos tend to be very self-reliant, very independent, very much kind of trying to slog it out on our own. I'm a Virgo as well. Very much trying to sort of, you know, following your inner light, which is great, following your very high standards of integrity, which is also great, but also, you know, just having a really, really clear vision of how this particular thing needs to be done. And sometimes that can be a bit of a block, a bit of a barrier against receiving help and receiving beneficial exchanges of creativity, or of help and assistance, or of ideas and inspirations, and the opportunity to work together in groups. This is one of your things that you really need to look at in July. So let's have a look at how you can do that, how you can best emerge in the wider community, into the wider community, and feel a greater sense of belonging and trust the community, rather than always relying on the self and the inner light. Hope that makes sense. Okay, so let's see what we've got. So Celtic Cross first, and then we'll do some oracle cards. So we've got Love Begins. Ah, that's beautiful. As I looked at that, I got a really strong sense of self-love. I got a really strong sense of the heart chakra opening and expanding, and a really strong sense of this water that's being poured out is water that's being poured out onto the earth, as we can see, poured out into a stream. So I'm going to just say the way that it feels, the way that it's sort of being shown. The way that it's being shown is that you're being asked in July to recognize yourself as a part of a collective energy of change, of a vibration of love, and something that is a part of an ebb and flow, a flowing energy that's flowing out onto the earth for the highest good of all. Recognizing that you are not working in isolation, that you are, you're one of many who are bringing change at this time. Not only that, okay, so this is a really, really great time for opening your heart to love in all respects. So your sense of belonging in the world and your sense of feeling able to contribute to the collective is very much going to come from a sense of self-love, and also an awareness that love is what you're bringing, and that it's through bringing that love that you will feel safer in connecting, rather than having ideas in your head about what you think is right and what you think is the right way to do things. Connect with others through love, through that loving vibration, and through your desire to bring love, and things will work out much, much better. I also feel that you are going to be receiving love, Virgo. So open your heart to that, allow it, breathe it in. I know things have been very tricky for Virgos for quite a while, and there have been some big changes that have had to happen, but I feel that because of the changes that you've made recently, you are going to start to see yourself differently, and others are going to start to see you differently, and as a result, you are going to start to receive more love, the love that you really deserve, the love that you actually put out into the world. So it's very much coming back towards you as well as you giving it out. It feels very balanced and very reciprocal. And there are two hands here, two people here pouring this love out onto the earth as well, just looking at the other interpretation again. So it feels as if in your desire to give love and give to the world, you are going to receive help. You're not going to be doing that on your own, whereas you might have been before in a relationship that was, you know, very much a push and pull, in a sense of everyone sort of pulling in different directions, and one person wants this and one person wants that, and, you know, a lot of ego stuff happening. This feels very much like two people pulling in the same direction, two people who come with the intention of being of service to the whole, who therefore pour their love out unconditionally and without struggle between them. So whether this is a love connection or a partnership or friendships or relationships in general, things are going to be much more harmonious for you in July. You're going to have a sense of much more love around you, much more love in your life, in your environment, and within yourself. So that's lovely. Okay, so what's crossing that? Fertility, love and fertility. Wow, be careful, Virgo. Just, with all the love that's going to be coming in, just make sure that you channel it in a way that you choose to channel it. The heart chakra is very, very much lit up in this card. So this is looking like a lot of creativity as well. It could be physical fertility, but it's, you know, very much a card when it's coupled with this one that just looks as if you have an awful lot to give and an awful lot to offer that you're holding within you, just waiting to pour out. I mean, what a great combination there. All of that creativity, all of that heart energy just being poured out. So if you've been blocked at all, if you've been restricted up until now, if there's been anything that's been holding you back, or if you've felt you've been holding that energy in, this is when you get to pour that energy out and just be who you came here to be and just do what you came here to do. So it works in both senses. It works in the emotional sense, and it also works in the sense of career and direction and just the beingness of who you are, just feeling that you're able to be yourself unfettered and free and fertile and flowing. Okay, gorgeous. So at the basis of all this, movement, choices, decisions, so it looks as if you've come from a base of having had to make some decisions recently that would give you that kind of creative fertility and freedom, and also the possibility of new love, new loving attitudes towards yourself, new loving ways and energies within your life in general. And what's over you is spiritual strength, a great deal of spiritual strength, relying on yourself much more, trusting your guides, trusting that they're guiding you, that they've got your back, that the way, the path ahead of you is clear. There's the smaller self here, but there's the greater self, the higher self that knows much more. There's the guides, you know, the ascended masters, all of those who work with you are so behind you and around you, shielding, protecting you, holding you up, and clearing a path ahead of you for the good that you came here to do. So let go of the little niggling worries, Virgo. I know we like a bit of a worry. Stay in that higher frequency as much as you possibly can, because you are, you know, in a time of flowering and birthing. Okay. You've just moved out of a period of new beginnings. Gemini had that there as well. So Virgos who have been coupled with Geminis, very interesting. You might find that you've just recently come to that new beginning through having let go of something, or let go of a phase of something that was connected to a Gemini, or something like that, whether it's a friendship or a partnership, relationship, whatever. So a new beginning, a complete new beginning for you, that's given you the potential to experience that freedom and create and fertility. So now you're going to be moving into a phase where you're very much looking at your material reality, and that feeling of, okay, well, can I do this? Can I go ahead? Can I trust that? I know I can trust the reality, the spiritual reality. I know I can trust the emotional and the creative reality. Can I trust the material reality? This is what you're moving into now, the base chakra, with all its issues of materiality and survival and grounding and being able to really feel that you are the master of your material and physical circumstances and reality. That's what you're moving into now, really wanting to manifest a good solid foundation for yourself materially. And your attitude towards it, which is great, towards everything, is victory, success, that you can do what you've set out to do, that you just need to stay in the right mindset. You've also got this trumpet here, so this is a very musical card as well. In some readings when it comes up, and I feel that this is, you know, if you're a Virgo who's a musician or someone else who's creative, it doesn't have to be traditional music. It might be chanting that you use as a part of your spiritual practice, anything to do with making sound at all, making sound, recording sound, creating sounds. This looks like a really, really good time for you generally to be spreading your message. It might not be a sounded message, it could be a written message, but it's like, you know, the trumpet call, the tumbrils are rolling, the trumpet's blaring, it's time, you know, it's time. Which is great, great attitude to have coming into this phase. In your environment, there is a sense of you've had to make some sacrifices, you've had to make some changes. You had to do it. You had to, you know, cut yourself loose from a situation that wasn't that was restrictive or that wasn't quite right for you. Some Virgos will still be wrestling with this. Some Virgos haven't come through this yet, and some people will be watching this before we get to July, and some people won't actually even be making these changes until later on. But for the vast majority of Virgos, there has been a huge change that has involved walking away from something that felt safe and secure, making a little bit of a sacrifice in order to, for the greater good. Okay, so your hopes and fears, hoping that you're seeing things clearly, the third eye vision, hoping that you're seeing the way ahead clearly. There's an option There's an opportunity sometimes when this card comes up, I feel, to develop your psychic awareness even more, because you're trying so hard to see what's ahead, trying to see around corners, trying to see whether you did the right thing. You might have more dream activity, or you might just find that your visualizations are getting clearer, and that your ability to visualize what you want, your manifesting ability, is becoming stronger as well, which is fantastic, because remember that we are the creators. So Virgos, if you have concerns now about this change and how it's all going to figure for you, there's never been a better time to get into a daily manifesting routine so that you can make real changes that stick and that will last, is what I'm hearing. Lovely. Okay, so what's the outcome for Virgo? Da-da-da. Fulfillment of wishes. Fulfillment of wishes. When you have the sun in your 11th house, in the house of wishes, hopes and wishes. I love it. Absolutely love it. Fantastic, fantastic month for you, Virgo, when you will be vindicated in the changes that you've made recently to set yourself free, when your worries and your niggles will start to descend, to start to, you know, disappear into the background, and you will start to emerge as the creator that you are, and to see that you are able to have great vision. Things haven't always worked out in the past the way that you thought they would. You haven't always seemingly made the best decisions materially, but in fact you have, because of the spiritual strength that you've gained from everything that you've been through, and because of this fantastic time that you're in now, which is the time which could only come now with all of this other preparation. It's absolutely all on divine timing, so stop worrying about it. There's time for everything, and this time is different. I'm going to pull one more card. Go out there, creator, and do it. The sacral chakra card, the card of manifestation, the card of creativity and creation, and the fulfillment of your wishes comes because you are a divine creator. I want to pick one more card. Positive movement forward. Virgo, I could keep pulling cards and it would just have the same message for you. Well done. Give yourself a big pat on the back. Well done for having faith in yourself. Well done for your new decision. Well done for the creative essence that is you. And have a fantastic time with all of that. I'm just going to quickly do your past, present and future cards. And yes, dolphins and mermaids for you as well, because I feel you need more water to be poured onto that earth that's been so parched for such a long time. Okay, so where are we? Past, present, future. So I would say a sense of the prosperity. This is what you're moving out of now. You've had a sense that you can create prosperity and abundance for yourself. And it was still, you know, while you were in this period of being restricted, there were opportunities. There were things around you that possibly you couldn't take because circumstances weren't quite right. But you've had a glimpse. This is what the cards are saying. You've had a glimpse that it is possible. So remember that when you had those glimpses but you couldn't take those opportunities, you were able to actually manifest and create those opportunities. Okay, very important. Self-employment. Okay, real affirmation for you that self-employment is the way to go for you. You need to be in control of your circumstances, your situations, the work you do. The world needs the work you do. You need to have that creative vision come onto the earth now. There is no question about it. And so if you're considering you know, making that leap, of course no one's going to tell you to just abandon ship and not take care of your responsibilities. But if you need to reassess things, reevaluate, reprioritize, please bear in mind that this is what you should at least be moving towards, if not completely embracing it, okay? Because that's where you're going to find your greatest success and the greatest fulfillment of your vision and your wishes and dreams. It's time. It's time for your voice. It's time for your vision. And so you are moving now into a period of worthiness. So July is very much going to be about you getting a sense of worthiness through filling up with that self-love and creativity, pouring it out onto the earth, receiving the love back as well for that, you know, reciprocal give and take, and beginning to know again who you are, what you bring, and what you deserve, just because of who you are, just because you exist as this creative divine being. Okay, have a fantastic July, Virgo. It's going to be amazing. And yes, you've got an amazing summer, an amazing few months ahead of you. So we'll look forward to that. I'll speak to you next month. If you'd like to book a reading with me, the links are below the video. And yeah, remember, if you want to get a free reading, let me know, comment and like and share the video, and make a comment letting me know that you would like to be entered into the free readings draw. Okay, that's it for now. Take care, and I'll speak to you in August. Bye.